It's not easy to find the right balance between evangelism, discipleship, and leadership development. I would even say it's impossible if we only depend on our human understanding and resources. So we need the Holy Spirit. That's supernatural. The ministry is supernatural, and it's kind of an art that is directed, orchestrated by God, and we need the Holy Spirit. But at the same time, there are certain times when we need to do more evangelism and focus more on evangelism. There are different times when we need to focus more on discipling. And there are other times when we need to more focus on leadership development. And what time to have which focus, that's the question of God's leading. Let me share a little personal example. I have a friend, he's a university student, and I disciple him. And so we do Bible studies, we share our lives, we pray together. He shares with me about his school, about his study, about his parents, about his other relationships, and we talk about it, we pray about it. But also, I see him serving others. So he is he's a relatively new Christian, and you know, the new Christians are the best evangelists because they still have the contact with the friends, non-Christian friends. It's you know, Christianity or relationship with Jesus is so new and so joyful that they naturally want to share. So I am only encouraging him in what he wants to do naturally. One day he told me, I just asked a friend, another friend of mine, and we went to share the gospel with other students. And that really makes me rejoice, because I don't have to be telling him, you should do it, you need to be do it. I don't have to even wait until he is fully trained and until he knows all of the apologetic answers to the difficult questions. I can only support him. I can only help him. I can only help him, for example, in preparing his own testimony and how he can effectively share his faith with non-Christians. And he's very keen on doing it on his own.